This is the third film we've done in the Northeast after I, Daniel Blake, and Sorry We Missed You. And we felt we had unfinished business. We've been back up to the Northeast. And what we found in a lot of these ex-mining villages, you know, were, you know, communities that were kind of traumatized and still hadn't recovered from the miner strike in 1984. The state has almost withdrawn. Libraries have gone, post offices have gone, banks have gone. The housing market has totally dropped. People were buying houses online, opportunists, and selling it on maybe 2 weeks later. And bringing up people from the south, dumped by other local authorities who were leaving. People who are, you know, people from tough backgrounds and people who've been kicked out of other houses elsewhere, or just moving people out because it was cheaper. So the people who lived there were felt that they were dumped upon. And then asylum seekers come into these places too because the housing was very, very cheap. So they felt they hadn't been consulted. They felt they had no agency in their lives. And but we always meet great people who hold out a hand of friendship to those people who are fleeing war, you know, have had the most unbelievable experiences. But we met great people too who try to understand the host community, try to understand their frustrations and actually listen to them. And I met brilliant, brilliant people who try to make connection between the two. And that takes intelligence, it takes empathy, it takes solidarity. And there was a big, big canvas to this story. We didn't want to stereotype any community, but we wanted to understand where hope comes from, how do we find nourishment for each other. And I think the gang have done a really terrific job.
Can you talk about what makes Ken such a special and important storyteller and what he's like to work with as a collaborator, as a partner?
He's a remarkable man. He's now 87. We've done over 14 feature films together. And right from the very beginning, he's had great curiosity about life. He wants to understand how power operates in our lives, and he listens to people. And we've got very different jobs. I'm a writer, Ken's a director, but we meet in the middle as filmmakers. And then to make a film, you need the talent of many, many, many people. So it's been, it's always been terrific. He creates a family. He creates a family. But also, he's a very, very tough collaborator. And you just have to find really good stories that that just work, you know, and a good issue doesn't make for a good story. We have to find a good story. So he's a very demanding collaborator. Filmmaking is a wonderful medium. You know, you can go in close and you can look into someone's eyes. You can see the community where they come from. You can see the environment in which they live. You even actually see the past. In this film, you actually do see the past, the effect of the miner strike. So it's got a tremendous richness. It's got music, it's got light, it's got humour, it's got tragedy, it's got fun. It's got absolutely everything it possibly can. Now, stories don't change the world, but what they do, they can be the catalyst to understand each other, to look at complexity, to try and untangle things. And so it's a wonderful medium. And what happened with Daniel Blake, we actually had something like 600 community screenings, you know, bringing it out to communities and libraries and workshops and all sorts of areas like that. And Studio Canal have been absolutely brilliant, and they're going to allow the same thing to happen, you know, with the Old Oak. So it's organisers who change the world, not filmmakers. It's easy to exaggerate their own importance, but I think they can add to the conversation and they can be a catalyst for discussion.